Welcome to this class. This is the topic of your zoology and this is first topic or first unit of your zoology and first long question also. The male reproductive system prepared by Dr. Sasmita Panigrahi, and in this topic we will discuss something about organs. What kind of male reproductive organs are there? Then what is the function of these organs? And how the pathway of sperm cells get connected. We will discuss all these things. In these objectives, in this present study, we identify the structures and major organs of male reproductive system along with the pathway of sperm cells in this organ system. Now, what is male reproductive system? The male reproductive system consist of a number of sex organs that are a part of human reproductive process. It produces, stores, release the male gametes also known as sperm. The male reproductive organs contains internal genital organ and external genital organ. In internal genital organ, we will study about testes, epididymis, vas deferens and different accessory glands, the glands associated with these internal organs. The gland is known as seminal vesicle, prostate gland and bulbourethral glands. The main gland is known as seminal vesicles. And the external genital organ, we will study about penis and scrotum. This is the male reproductive organs. In this male reproductive organs, testes. The testes is 2 in number and each testes is covered, outer covering with scrotum. Then each testes connected with different vessels or tubes is known as epididymis. Then each epididymis is connected with vas deferens, then it is connected all these things in towards the urethra. This is the structure in overview: testes, epididymis, then ducts of deferens, then bulbourethral gland, prostate gland is present each side, then testes is 2 in number, then all the tube are connected in the urethra. Urethra and penis is the common passage of semen and urine. This is the front view and this is the total diagram of your male reproductive organ. Then external genital organ, we will study about penis and scrotum. The penis is the organ by which sperm is introduced into the female and it contains spongy tissue that become torsed and erect when it is filled with blood. This is the scrotum. Scrotum is known as the outer layer of the testes. A patch of skin is present, lower part of the abdominal wall. It is attached with the testes. The scrotum keeps the testes at a temperature slightly cooler than the body temperature. Then next, internal genital organ, testes, epididymis, vas deferens, and this is the glands. The testes are 2 oval shaped male organs and that produces sperms and hormone testosterone. Testosterone is known as the male sex hormone. This is the total structure of the testes. Each testes a number of tubes are there and each testes contains the cells. Cells is known as each tubule is known as seminiferous tubules. And Leydig cells also present inside the testes which nourishes these cells. Then testes is contains septum separate from each testes contains a number of tubes separate from each other by the help of septum. And it contains cavity of tunica vagilaris and each testes is connected with last end is known as spermatic cord. This is the total structure of your testes. Then each testis is made up of tightly coiled structure called seminiferous tubules. Among the tubules are the cells that produces testosterone. Testosterone is known as male sex hormone, which is mainly control the all the sexual character of the male. Then this is the epididymis. The epididymis is a tightly coiled tubes against the testicles, and it acts as a maturation and storage places of sperm. When sperm are produced, they are first stored in the epididymis. The epididymis is divided. The showing A structure is head of epididymis. B is body of epididymis. C portion, which is seen, is tail of epididymis, and D is vast differences. Then vast differences. Testis, the tube connected to epididymis, all the tube connected to vast difference. The vast difference, the lower structure, the vast difference is a thin tube that starts from the epididymis to the urethra in the penis. Urethra is the urinary discharge pathway. They transport sperm from the epididymis in anticipation of ejaculation. Then accessory gland, we will study about seminal vesicle, prostate gland, bulbourethral gland. These glands produce nourishes fluids for the sperms that enter into the urethra. This is the seminal vesicle, the structure of the seminal vesicle. The seminal vesicles are sac-like structure attached to the vas deferens. Two sides of vas deferens contains the seminal vesicles at one side of the bladder. This is the seminal vesicle. One side, the bladder, contains seminal vesicle. They produce a sticky yellowish fluid that contains fructose. In seminal vesicles, it contains a fluid-like structure which is yellow in color and contains more fructose. Then next, prostate gland. The prostate gland surrounds the ejaculatory ducts at the base of the urethra. Urethra means your urinary passage. In male reproductive part, the prostate gland is present just below the bladder, urinary bladder. The prostate gland is responsible for making the production of semen, a liquid mixture of sperm cells and fluid and seminal fluid. Then bulbourethral gland, it is shortcut name is Cowper's gland. Cowper's gland is more famous as bulbourethral gland. The bulbourethral glands are two small glands located on the side of the urethra just below the prostate gland. Prostate gland is present below the urethra, but bulbourethral gland or Cowper's gland are the small gland located on the side of the urethra just below the prostate gland. These glands produce a clear, slippery fluid that empties directly into the urethra. Three types of gland is mainly present. The main function of male reproductive system is to produce sperm cells and deliver them to the female reproductive system to produce a zygote, and that zygote becomes the future baby. It contains the external and internal genital organs, which are essential for continuous reproduction of life. The male reproductive part produces sperm, and the female reproductive part produces ova. When ova is contains n number of chromosomes, and sperm contains also n number of chromosomes. When n for in female and for male, when combined with each other, they produces zygote, which is 2n number, which stores 2n number of chromosome, and that 2n number of chromosome produces embryo and future baby. So we study how the sperm is produces and what is the function of the sperm एंड हाउ दिस स्पर्म इज ट्रांसफर टू द फीमेल जेनिटल ऑर्गन द स्पर्म स्पर्म इज प्रोड्यूसेस फ्रॉम मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट इट मूव एंड कैरी द जेनेटिक इंफॉर्मेशन टूअर्ड्स एग इट कंटेन्स इट डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री पार्ट स्पर्म इज मेनली मोटाइल मोटाइल मीन्स इट्स मूवमेंट इज प्रेजेंट विद द हेल्प ऑफ फ्लैजेला टेल इट इज थ्री मेन पार्ट इट कंटेन्स थ्री मेन पार्ट हेड हेड इज द लार्ज हेड रीजन एंड विच कंटेन्स डी एन ए द मिडिल पार्ट इज नॉन एज नेक इट इज द नेरो एंड इट कंटेन्स माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया एंड टेल द वेव लाइक मोशन ऑफ द फ्लैजेलम प्रेजेंट टू स्पर्म towards it produces and it moves towards the ova then we will study spermatogenesis how sperms are produces it is the shortcut method and it is the another long question first long question is male reproductive system and second long question we will study spermatogenesis what is spermatogenesis spermatogenesis it is the simple short topic But in next class we study detail about spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis is the formation of sperm cells, and it takes place in the seminiferous tubules. Seminiferous tubules are the structural and functional unit of your testes. It stores, it produces sperm mother cells, and inside the sperm mother cells, sperms are produces, nourishes. Means take food from the nourishing cells and it mature after maturation it moves towards the female genital organs for intercourse in the intercourse and it produces the future baby it the process is known as the formation of sperm with the help of spermatogenesis process is known as spermatogenesis or spermatogonia mother cells sperm are produces the process is known as spermatogenesis in spermatogenesis process it is the meiosis it is the cell cycle meiosis cell cycle occurs or cell division occurs and it produces four sperms and these sperms are known as motile and the structure of sperm is here it contains head middle piece and tail then it is the end of the process the sperms are produces thank you